Alright, so today's lecture is sequences of real numbers. First of all, what's a sequence? I guess you all hear me, right? A sequence. Of real numbers is a function. It's nothing but a function f from the set of natural numbers into R. We will use the following notation. Well, usually you see the value of a function is denoted like this, right? F of let's say n. But instead of this, we will use this. So we will write fn instead of f of n. Okay? So that will be notation. And for sequences, it is customary to use not f, g, h, but a, b, c, or x, y, and z. So usually our sequence will be denoted by x or a, okay? And the value of this sequence at n, which is x of n, will be usually denoted by x sub n, okay? X sub n. Or we will denote the sequence by a, and again its value will be denoted by just a sub n instead of a n. Okay? All right. Let's see some examples of sequences. For example, x n denoted by this minus 1 to the power n is a sequence, right? And let's say a n a n, let's say n plus 1 over 2 to the power n are some sequences, right? And usually we denote this sequence x by x sub n. When we write this, we mean the set of all elements, the sequence x n, and usually we just write this as like this, okay? And the sequence A, instead of writing it this way, we just write it like this. N plus 1 over N. Okay? Let's say this is the sequence A, N, and we will write it usually like this. You have seen sequences, I guess, in the first year course, right? In detailed way. We will in this course consider properties like convergence, boundedness, Cauchy sequence, and so on, and we will see that why they are important, especially in the construction of real numbers. You know that so we will see that, let me write here, we will see that why sequences are important in the construction of real numbers. Okay, real numbers, in the construction of real numbers, we will use sequences of rational numbers, and we will basically go over all the details And the reason we will go over the details is not just to review real numbers, but we will see that that construction carryovers to all metric spaces, and it's a very fundamental construction, namely construction of a completion of a metric space. That's something very important. And that construction of completions of metric spaces, will just mimic the construction of real numbers from rational numbers. Okay, that's why it is important. All right. To do so, we will, we have to construct couple of things. First, some basic definitions. Evet. Yok. Yani reel sayıların construction'ını birkaç değişik şekilde yapmak mümkün. Construction of real numbers can be done in some, ways. One of them is dedekind cuts, but we will not go into that. We will use sequences. We will basically do the following. We know what natural numbers is, and then we have integers, and then we have rational numbers, and we will just write, we will construct rational numbers as completion of Q using sequences. Okay. First, some definitions. And these definitions also, although they, seem to be, special to real numbers, actually they are not. We will see that these definitions carry over to all metric spaces and so on. Okay. All right. A sequence. A sequence, let's say xn of real numbers is called bounded from above, and respectively from below, if there is some real number m, respectively real number little m, so that xn is less than m, respectively xn is greater than little m for all n in n. Okay, so a sequence is bounded from above if there's a real number, so that all the terms of the sequence is less than that number. And similarly, it is bounded from below if there is a real number, so that all the terms of the sequence is greater than that number. So, picturally, it's something like this. Okay, this is the, let's say, real axis. And there is some little m, let's say, and big m. And if we have only little m and the terms of the sequence are like this, they are all here, xn's. Don't see this big m right now. Let's say we have only little m and all the terms are greater than this. Then we say that xn is bounded from below. And if we have a big M like this, so that all the terms of the sequence is less than this, then we say that xn is bounded from above. If it is bounded from above and below, we simply say that the sequence is bounded. Okay, a sequence is set to be bounded if it is bounded from above and below. And if you let, for example, if it is bounded from above and below, in this case, let's say, okay, k to be maximum of okay, this number, absolute value of this and absolute value of this, then suppose it is bounded from above and below, let's just choose k to be the absolute value of this, the maximum of the absolute values of little m and big m, then xn is just less than right, xn is just less than minus greater than minus k and less than k for all n, right, or equivalently xn is just less than k. And we will usually write like this, you know, if a sequence is bounded, we will just say that there is some real number so that absolute value of all xn's is less than k. Okay. Some examples. For example, xn, which is just, let's say, n square, this is the sequence 1, 4, 9, 16, and so on. Clearly, this is bounded from below and not bounded from above, right? This is bounded from below by which number? Well, there are, of course, many lower bounds, for example, by 0, right? By 1 also. And this sequence is bounded, right? Is bounded. It is bounded from below by 0 and bounded from above by 1, right? So xn over xn, which is n over n plus 1, is always less than 1. So it is bounded by 1. Okay. Okay, I'll remind you convergence of a sequence of real numbers. Convergence of sequences. I guess you have seen this concept also in first year course, calculus course. We will just remind you that, and then we will see relation between convergence and other concepts in more detail. Okay. Let AN be a sequence. Of real numbers, and L any real number, we say that AN converges to L. Converges to L. If what happens? If for any epsilon positive given, there is some index n zero. So there is some index n zero. So that n greater than or equal to n zero implies a n minus l is less than epsilon. Okay. So this should hold for all epsilon. Okay. You will give me an epsilon, I will choose some n0, so that if n is larger than n0, then the distance between an and l is less than epsilon. So picturally this corresponds to the following. Here is some l. Okay. You give me an epsilon. Okay. And I will choose some index, so that this index of course may depend on L and epsilon, so that after that index all the terms of the sequence will be inside this interval. So AN0 will be somewhere here, AN0 plus 1 will be somewhere here, and AN0 plus 2 will be somewhere here. If you give me a smaller epsilon, I will choose possibly a bigger n0. Okay? And the same thing will hold. If this happens for all epsilon, in other words, if I can find an n0 for any epsilon you give me, then we say that the sequence is convergent. In this case, we write limit an is equal to L. Okay, so when I write limit an equals L, I mean exactly this. Sometimes we write this, or sometimes I write this, but usually we will just write this because there is only one variable. And when we talk about sequence of real numbers, we just talk about limit as n goes to infinity. Okay. Any questions so far? I guess you remember this kind of stuff. Maybe not in great detail. Actually, you have seen this, I guess, also in advanced calculus course, right? In Math 251. So it is just a reminder for you. All right, let me give some examples. Let's consider the sequence an given by 1 over n. So what is this sequence? This is the sequence 1, 1 over 2, 1 over 3, 1 over 4, and so on, right? And you see, as n increases, right, as n increases, the terms of the sequence gets closer and closer to 0, right? Here is 1, 1 over 2, 1 over 3, 1 over 4, and so on. 1 over n, and so on. And, you know, from this observation, we know that, you know, we see that limit of this sequence is 0. So that's our guess. Let me write it here. Claim, we claim that limit of 1 over n a n is just 0. Well, it seems evident, right, this conclusion, but we have to prove it if we are, you know, if this is a math, you know, mathematical statement, then it needs a proof. We have the definition, and we have to show that this sequence satisfies the conditions of that definition, so that its limit is equal to 0. Let's see that. So what we have to do? Given any epsilon, we need to find an n0 so that you know, n greater than n0 should imply an is less than epsilon. What is an? An is this, so this should be less than epsilon. But you see, when you have this, you see that this n should be greater than 1 over epsilon. So we just need to choose that n large enough, greater than 1 over epsilon. So if I choose my n0, an integer greater than this, and then if n is larger than n0, then this will be automatically satisfied. So I just need to choose my n0 larger than 1 over epsilon. And I can do this. Why is that? Because epsilon is just a positive number. 1 over epsilon is another positive number. And the set of natural numbers is unbounded. So I can choose such an n. So that's the, you know, idea of the proof. Now I will write it in a more, you know, mathematically correct way. How we will proceed? Okay, let epsilon be given. Then, since epsilon is a positive number, 1 over epsilon is a real number. Okay. Since the set of natural numbers is unbounded, there is some n0 so that n0 is greater than 1 over epsilon, right? Because if I cannot find such an n0, then it would mean that 1 over epsilon is an upper bound for the set of natural numbers. But this is unbounded, so No matter which real number you give me, I can always find a natural number which is larger than that number. So there is such an n zero. Then if n greater than n zero, we have what? We have you see xn minus zero, or let me write L, xn is just 1 over n, L is just 0 in our case, so this is just 1 over n, but since n is larger than n0, this is less than, first of all, this is a natural number, so it is 1 over n, but this is less than 1 over n0, but 1 over n0 is less than epsilon. Because of this, okay, and this finishes the argument, the proof. Why is that? You see what we have done. You give me an epsilon. Right, you give me an epsilon. I choose some n0. Okay, satisfying this condition. And if n is greater than n0, then we have this difference is less than epsilon. Okay, less than epsilon. Hence, limit a n is equal to L, which is in this case 0. Okay, any questions about this proof? Tabii. Hayır. Yani şimdi biz tanımı verdik. Sadece o tanıma bağlıyız şu anda. Hani o tanımın şartları sağlanıyorsa o zaman bu dizi o tanımda söylenen özelliğe sahiptir. O da neydi? İşte dedik ki limiti L'dir. L'de bu durumda sıfırı seçtik. O zaman sadece tanımı kontrol etmem lazım. Senin söylediğin şeylerle tabii ki alakası var. Onu da göreceğiz hani bugün veya bir sonraki derste, ama öyle şeyler yapmak zorunda değiliz. Hani bunu bir oyun gibi görün. Right, this thing is like a game. You have some objects and then you have some you know rules, and using those rules you just play the game. You can come up with an argument which is valid, mathematically valid, and if that argument, shows you, some fact, proves some fact, then that fact, is proved. As in this case, I gave you the definition of convergence. So if you can come up with an argument, so that argument is compatible with that definition, then you are done. You don't have to import some facts you learned from, other courses and so on. We will see that, of course, being, convergent is related to boundedness and so on. But you have to always, need to play with the rules given to you, okay? And those rules, what are they? They are either definitions or the facts we prove in this course, okay? Anlaşıldı mı? Ama senin dediğin şeylerle de alakasını göreceğiz birazdan, hani convergence'ın. Tamam, şimdi bir de ters bir örnek yapalım. Now let's see an example of a sequence which is not convergent. Okay, so let an let an be the sequence given by this rule. An is this sequence. For n equals 0, for example, it is 1. For n equals 1, it is minus 1. For n equals 2, it is 1. For n equals 3, minus 1. So it goes like this. 1, minus 1. 1, minus 1. Well, it is clear that, you know, this sequence is not convergent because the terms of the sequence are not getting closer and closer to any real number. Some terms are 1 and some terms are minus 1. So you can say that, you know, some of the terms are close to 1 and some terms are close to minus 1. But that's not what we mean from convergence. Convergence means all the terms of the sequence should be close enough to any to a given real number, and that closeness should be under our control. We should be able to make the terms of the sequence close to that limit point as much as we want by choosing epsilon. And in this case, it doesn't look like that, you know, there is a limit point. But how can we state this observation or prove this observation mathematically? We will do it by contradiction. So I claim that efendim, neyi nereden başlattığına göre değişir. Birden başlatırsan haklısın, sıfırdan başlatırsan birden başlar. Yani ben çok şeyden emin değilim. Hani natural number'lara sıfırı koyalım mı, koymayalım mı? Burada sıfırı koymuş gibi kabul ediyorum. Tamam mı? Yani. Efendim? Ha, orada birden mi başlattım? Ha, anladım, anladım. Tamam, anladım. İyi, isterseniz öyle yapalım. Tamam. Şöyle, minus one. Tamam mı? Okay. Şimdi, so, what is the claim? Claim is this: limit a n does not exist. Okay, does not exist. So that's the claim. Proof. Well, I'll prove this by contradiction. So suppose on the contrary that suppose on the contrary that limit a n exists, and that limit is equal to L for some real number L. Okay. How the proof will proceed? Well, it will proceed as follows. Let me first draw you a picture. Okay. Here is L. Well, If this is the limit, I know that after some index, all the terms of the sequence should be close to L as much as I want. For example, if I choose my epsilon to be 0.5, so I'll go just 0.5 units to this side, 1 over 2, L minus 1 over 2. And after some index, all the terms of the sequence should be inside this interval, right? After some index, there will be some n0, so that an0, an will be here if n is greater than n0. However, if you look at the terms of the sequence, they are either 1 and minus 1. So it means that both 1 and minus 1 should be inside this interval. However, the length of this interval is just one unit, right? Because this is the center point is L, this point is L minus 1 over 2, and this point is L plus 1 over 2. So the length of this interval is just one unit, and I ask from this interval to contain both 1 and minus 1. The distance between 1 and minus 1 is 2 units. So that's the contradiction, okay? Now from this picture, I see the contradiction. But that's not an argument. That's not a valid argument. That's just the idea. So I just keep this here and then proceed using, mathematical arguments. So we assume that L exists. We assume that L exists, limit exists. And you see that I use this 1 over 2 in this, argument. I described you. So I should make use of this, thing. How we will do this? Well, since I assume that limit exists, the definition should hold for any epsilon. But I see that it doesn't hold, right, for epsilon equals 1 over 2. Okay. So we assume this. Pardon. Let epsilon to be 1 over 2, which is a positive number. Okay. Since we have limit an equals L, there is some, right? There is some index okay, so that n greater than n0 implies an minus L is less than epsilon, right? So this means what? This means an, which is just an minus L less than 1 over 2 for all n greater than n0. Okay, but you see, if n is, for example, an even number, then an is just 1. If it is odd number, it is minus 1. So in particular, 1 minus L is less than 1 over 2, and minus 1 minus L is less than 1 over 2. Right? By choosing an even integer larger than n0, I get this. And by choosing an odd integer larger than n0, I get this. So I have both of these inequalities. And this will give me the contradiction because L is close to 1 and minus 1 at the same time with a distance less than 1 over 2. And that's not possible, right? How can we see that that's not possible? I can see it this way. You see, 2 is equal to, then 2 is equal to what? This is the distance between 1 and minus 1, right? And I can write this as 1 minus L plus L minus 1. So you see, I just added and subtracted L to this expression. I haven't changed it, but now I do this. You see, I can group these like this, and I use triangle inequality. So by the triangle inequality, this is less than 1 minus L plus L minus minus 1. Yes, 1 minus, okay, let me write one more step, 1 minus L, and this is of course just L plus 1, right? L plus 1. And actually you see that this is just absolute value of this. Okay, let me write this way. 1 minus L plus minus 1 minus L, right? This is the same thing. Negative of a real number has the same absolute value. However, I know that this is less than 1 over 2. And this is less than 1 over 2, right? Here is. Both of them are less than 1 over 2. And this is just equals 1. So we obtain the following contradiction. 2 is less than 1, which is a clear contradiction. Okay, so this finishes the proof. Hence, we arrived at this contradiction because of what? Because of the following, right? Here I said that suppose on the contrary that limit a n exists and equals L for some real number L. That assumption, that supposition led us to this contradiction. Hence, that supposition is not correct. Hence, limit a n, sorry, so limit of minus 1 to the power n does not exist. Well, you see that here, this was something clear, right? I mean, you may think that why do we have to write, this thing, which is very obvious in so much detail. The reason is that, okay, there is some idea, and that's very, of course, precious, in mathematics, but writing that idea using mathematical arguments is also very important. And this is how you can make mathematicals, how you make mathematical arguments. If you wanna prove something, you have to use mathematical arguments. Just drawing pictures is not, it contains the maybe most important idea, but that's just an idea. How you present it using mathematical argument is very important, and unless you do that, it is not accepted. Okay, that's why I write, you know, this obvious looking things in detail, and we will of course expect you to get used to this kind of ideas and you know, write down such arguments when you are asked. Any questions so far? Evet. Okay, if you don't have a question, let me give a break, 10 minutes break. After the break, we will continue.